Yo, what's going on, everybody? It's your boy. Coming back at you with some more For Honor, but we don't actually have gameplay. Now, this is my first video back from taking my little bit of a break. If you guys didn't know, I took like a week and a half-ish off of like streaming and stuff. Still had videos out there, but I haven't actually been on For Honor in like 2 weeks or so. But I got on the game and I was like, hey, maybe I'll do some gameplay. And then I was like, yeah, well, still not really feeling it. So I'm not going to be doing that. Instead, I'm going to be doing something that a lot of people used to like on my channel, and maybe me unfortunately made too many of them, because then people expected them, and that is tier lists, right? Except this one is not called a tier list. It's called the smell index, if you didn't know. Basically, that's how I like to rank characters, if they're smelly or not. Basically, the higher in smell you are, the higher up you would be on that list, and then all the way up to the Sultan of Smell. So we go through the characters, and basically, you know, it's not even really like a strength, I guess, tier list. It's more of just like annoyance level, I guess, per se. You know, it's my own personal opinion. This is just funny stuff. I figured I'd do one for year five, since a lot of characters are going to be soon maybe getting changes. We'll just, you know, have a little baseline right here for a before, and maybe we'll do it after once characters get changes. We go through a list. It's basically, you know, how you would do a standard list, S through D. D being dog shit. The S, there's only going to be one thing in S, and that is the Sultan of Smell, the most smelliest character in the entire game. And then, yeah, everything in between. I'll do some brief explaining. I don't want it to be like a 50-minute video, so I'll kind of go over it roughly for the characters, and yeah, let's go ahead and get into it. All right, and obviously we'll start off in the D. With the D, we have the Orochi. Some people might disagree with this. People might think Orochi's smelly because of, you know, light, I guess. Me personally, I have basically a little tip for that. It's blocking, but I know some people say it's a little bit hard. I can understand that, but other than that, character still doesn't really have an opener. He does have his finisher unblockable, which is pretty nice, and you know, good Orochis obviously can still do really well. You can do well with any character in the game, but I just find that he doesn't have too much really going for him in terms of opening up characters. Plus, Reflex Guard is obviously just a detriment to any character who has Reflex Guard. Static is just way better. We don't need Reflex Guard in the game, personally, in my own opinion. But it's just, you know, people mostly complain about Orochi because of lights, and honestly, he's not that great in terms of anything else. I mean, the lights can be stopped pretty easily. If he keeps attacking in light chains, then you can get pretty easy parries. So Orochi doesn't have that much going for him, personally. Well, next up in the D, we have Armusha. I don't think I really need to say too much about this guy. He's garbage. He's not good at all. Whether it's his incredibly slow opening heavies, which is essentially like swinging underwater, or the fact that you literally just need to block to stop any of his chains, unless it's heavies or whatnot, or just the fact that, you know, he has no opener, and if you got an Armusha and a gank, you just lock on the other person, and it's like super, super easy, because all of his like deadly feints will go to the same side, so you get easy parries on that. Yeah, it's pretty hard. The fact that you can still pretty reliably back dodge any of his combos does make it pretty difficult as well. They also took away like my man's jumping. He can't even jump anymore. It's freaking weird. What happened to that? He just doesn't even leave the ground. That's not even really like a nerf per se, but it's just weird. But yeah, the main thing is just like, dude, he has no chance of getting anything open. His blade blockade is very inconsistent as well. You know, it doesn't get damage confirmed on pretty much anything. The most damage you get confirmed is on the ring, the bell, and it just kind of sucks. But he is getting changes, so hopefully those are good. But at the moment, Armusha is bad, very bad. Next up in the D tier, we have Nusha. Nusha is just, I think, a little bit inconsistent with a lot of stuff, right? Her lights can be pretty fast and kind of hard to deal with. Caltrops are a bit annoying. Yeah, we understand that. But traps are very, very inconsistent, essentially, if you're just not... basically, you can't just parry. That's like the only thing. Just don't parry, and then you're fine. You can emote out of them. You can, you know, dodge. You can do all that crap. But it is fun to play Nusha. Plus, her deflect again is not exactly confirmed. A lot of the time, you have to like change the direction. So a lot of the time, it like defaults, and they can still block it. I think it's the only deflect that's not an unblockable. Don't quote me on that. Yeah, so Nusha just has some trouble. Believe me, you can still sauce people up with Nusha, and her heavies and stuff do a good amount of damage, don't get me wrong, but I feel like you just really don't see too many Nushas because they just have trouble, because their whole thing is kind of based around the traps, and the traps are very, very inconsistent, making her kind of shit. Next up in the D tier, we got the Shaolin, mainly due to the fact, well, first off, Monkey, right? How can you hate Monkey? he's got to be low on the list, right? That would be just disrespectful if you put him anywhere higher. Also, his main thing is getting into cheese stance, and he can have some issues getting into cheese stance. He has a lot of really cool mix-up potential. I don't think he's necessarily a bad character. I think he can actually do pretty well. But, like, I don't find too many people getting mad against a Shaolin. Like, if people are continuing to spam, like, cheese stance into kick, you just dodge it and you get a free GB. So, you got to get a little bit more... you got to get a little bit more sauce with you. Maybe you go in and you throw the sun kick strike, or the sun kick sweep, rather. And then you get, some different stuff on there. So getting into his chi stance is the main thing, because just throwing, like, a normal heavy is really hard, and sometimes backstep lights don't always work. You end up attacking them rather than doing an actual backstep. So that's unfortunate indeed. But, His dodge attack is very good, and I can understand maybe people don't like that, because if you like external people and stuff, it's super good. Like, it can fully counter like Highlander's kick caber just from like a single dodge like that. So that can be kind of annoying, but I really just don't think that Shaolin's really up there. Plus the reflex guard, not helpful either. And yeah, I mean, it's just Monkey, so he's one of the more light characters, I'd say. And the final character in the D tier is going to be the Xianhu. First off, Drip God. Someone with this much drip cannot be that smelly, because it's just the freshest materials. But regardless of that, he's decent in Force. I actually really enjoy playing him in Force. There's some things, though, like you can only throw his left unblockable in externals, because his right sometimes doesn't even hit the target right in front of you. Kind of strange. A lot of his stuff can just be negated by blocking. It doesn't have great openers. You'll find most of the people who like aren't super smelly just have trouble opening up characters, where when we have like 28 characters, and I'd say a good 20 to 23 of them probably have a decent opener. So some of these characters, just it's kind of rough for them. People say, like, yeah, he's got a light unblockable, but it's very slow, actually. It's still pretty parryable. And just in general, he's a dodge attack specialist, but he doesn't have enhanced dodge attacks, which is kind of strange. Also, one is a heavy and one is the light input, but they're both like light parries. So if you get parried on him, it's kind of unfortunato. So you don't want that per se. It's kind of... You just have to wait and then maybe get a dodge attack in when you dodge out someone's attack, and it's just not the most fun when you're in 1v1 scenarios. But he does have some cool like stuff that you can do with like his zone and chain combos and fours, but again, I don't think Xianhu's that much of an issue. Now we'll be moving into the C-tier. C-tier is ones that might be a little bit more smelly to people, kind of more consensed, but I don't think that they're going to be still as, much of an issue. Like, they're just not as dog shit as D. First up we have in here is Peacekeeper. Some people might think Peacekeeper is a little bit higher, but, she does have that new thing where once she gets a bleed on, she can get a lot of pressure with those unblockables, and I can understand how that's kind of smelly with, 50-50s and, the soft feints and everything. So I understand that to an extent. But other than that, again, Peacekeeper still struggles from having reflex guard and not a ton of damage still. She does have more damage in her like heavies and normal heavies now, but still a lot of it's bleed loaded. So I mean, I guess thick blood won't be much of an issue anymore, but again, they just, it doesn't do as much damage. Like 15 damage on a heavy attack is pretty low. So that's kind of where she struggles, but I can understand where people would kind of get annoyed at like the unblockables and stuff after bleeding, what have you. So that's why she's C. Next up in the C tier, we've got Lawbringer. Now Lawbringer's a character I don't like, just personally. I know they do, having issues. My main, I guess, issues with the smelling would be, his punish is pretty insane, out of stamina. And also he has the fucking electric boogaloo GB to where when they dodge backwards, he will like suction cup his way to you. But Lawbringer hasn't been as good recently. This doesn't have hyper armor anymore. Through the history of this, Lawbringer with shove on block was super, super, super annoying. And then when this was hyper armored, that was pretty annoying as well, because it was just shove on red. So that's a thing that he hasn't really had as much anymore. So now he kind of has to do a little bit more with the tools that he has given, which makes him, kind of fall down in here. I think his damage still makes him like a decent character, not super strong or super weak. But yeah, the main things that why he's like lower on here is like now that's not too much of an issue, his shove. And yeah, that's pretty much it for Lawbringer. I don't really like him, so I'm not going to talk about him much more. All right, next up in the C tier, we have Raider. Now, Raider's a character that who was very, very weak, then got reworked, was very, very strong, and has slowly just kind of fallen down the totem pole. More so, I find really all you really got, because now, like, you don't have stun tap. They took that away from him, took dodge GB away from him, which, to be honest, needed to go. Some of his damage has been reduced, and honestly, all he has now is kind of, you just got to delay some heavies and hyper armor trade with people, which is, you know, not a good idea, because Raider still does good damage, and he can still get you with some of the soft faint GBs and whatnot. But I still find it's a little bit more difficult now for Raider to do much. Again, he doesn't have too much of a reliable opener. I mean, like, yeah, you could just faint and do a soft fainted GB, but yeah, that's not the greatest. I mean, he does have a stampede charge, which can help out for stuff, but there's better moves in the game, like crashing charge, and he can get interrupted and whatnot. So Raider, you know, he just has some issues. Like, if you can't open up and someone's kind of blocking just against you and guessing right, I mean, it's going to be pretty hard for Raider. So he could use probably a little bit of help. All right, now we have Highlander. I feel like some people might think that Highlander's higher up on this list, but I personally don't think so. The main things that I'd say would probably annoy me would be, I mean, like, yeah, his second light is pretty fast. And then main thing, too, is probably the phantom range on of a lot of his attacks. Like, you know those attacks where you're like, oh, that didn't hit me, but it ends up hitting you. Yeah, that's a pretty big issue on Highlander. But, you know, a skillful Highlander who's able to dodge out, correctly do kicks, caber toss, all that stuff is good. He does pretty high damage as well, but he's slow on pretty much all of his other attacks besides his lights. So, you know, regardless of if the lights are super fast, I don't think you'll see too many Highlanders just only light spamming you, which is probably not the greatest strategy. So I don't think that the Highlander's too bad. I think it's actually pretty pretty skillful character. Next up, we got Valkyrie. Valkyrie, I guess people's main issue would be bashing. I just assume that's the main thing. I, you know, personally don't like to just only use the bash. I find that she has such good mix-up potential. And with other stuff that you can do in terms of, like, you know, maybe you miss a bash. Like, that can even be, like, a pretty good, like, skillful thing to do. Then you throw a heavy maybe after. But I think probably the bash would be the main thing that gets under people's skin. And she does have, you know, kind of quick follow-up lights, but you find most people follow-up light to the top, which you can kind of expect. Other than that, she has okay damage. You know, she had higher damage. Her finisher heavy does pretty good damage, but the openings and stuff don't do quite as much. Her sweep's a bit more safe now. It used to be a free GB if you actually dodged it and missed, so that probably would have put Valk even lower on the tier. But I find that she's pretty good. She's got fun moves to do. The shoulder pin's good. I don't find too many people complaining about Valkyrie, so I don't think she could go really anywhere besides C. All right, next up we have Shinobi. This one might be controversial. I feel like most people think that just the existence of Shinobi is smelly. And you know what? I can kind of agree to an extent of that. But, you know, after having to get, you know, my 7 reputations on this character, I knew the character wasn't that great to begin, so people just end up doing, the, you know, this shit and just standing in the back. You know, I get that. That's why he has a bit of smell. But the character is so fucking bad. Like, he's just not good at all. His double dodge kick can be dodged pretty easily. You know, his lights aren't that great. You know, his zone at least can be fainted now, which is pretty sick, but the character has reflex guard. He's got the lowest health in the game. He can get easily GB'd out of trying to do his kick. Dude, he just fucking sucks. He's garbo, so I don't think you can really rate him. Like, I would want to put him in D, but I do understand the people who are, like, in ganks, and then they just wait for fucking range GBs to go and get a lot of stack damage, which, that type of stuff, that's not fun. I can understand that. Like, the Shinobis, you know, you all know what I'm talking about, the ones that run away and then just go into ranged attacks and stuff. Yeah, those are annoying, don't get me wrong, but the character is pretty shit. I was trying to think of a more eloquent way to say it, but that's all I can say. He's bad. All right, next we have Nabushi in this. You know, you could probably argue that Nabushi could still be in D. I don't find her annoying really at all. You do have a lot of different option select methods with her, and she does have now a lot more stuff with her undodgeables and being able to, you know, you kind of see a lot of Nabushi's just simply zone and then either do a kick or, you know, go zone into the unblockable finisher. Or unblockable, why did I say unblockable? Undodgeable finisher. I can understand why, I don't know, a zone spamming Nabushi might be annoying, but or one that spaces you very well. But other than that, Nabushi could potentially be in D. I mean, I think she's a much better character now, but with some of the changes that she's gotten and a lot more fun being able to chain, like, different stuff out of, you know, out of the out of like the dodge attacks as well, being able to change that. I think you can change it chain into a kick. No, you can't change and chain to a kick. But yeah, she's got more options now. Might be a little bit annoying with the zone spam and bleed and shit, but I don't think she's that bad personally. She could go in D, but I'm just gonna put her in C. Well, now we're going into the B tier. This one is basically, you know, they just got a little bit more smell to them than those who are in the C. Simple as that. And starting off in here, we have the Centurion. After Centurion's rework, I feel like they kind of took away the true essence of Scent, but they did give us Vinny from the fucking Bronx, so I like that. But essentially, Scent now is whether you're just gonna feint a punch or not, or continue to punch them in the face, you know, all that crap. It's basically, are you gonna do the unblockable heavy, or are you gonna do a soft feint GB into a wall? So it's essentially just, it's just a guessing game. It's like, is the Scent gonna feint his punch? Is the Scent gonna feint the heavy? You know, you do what you gotta do. That's lots of options, select zones in there as well. The kick is pretty decent now because it's a little bit faster. But at the end of the day, he's still not like as annoying as some of the other characters in the game. He does have a lot of different options though. If he had a dodge attack, he probably would be a bit higher on this list, admittedly. But you know, just basically spamming this and everything and all those different moves with the punch and being able to feint it, that kind of just gives him a lot of pressure, so I can understand how that's annoying. So that's why he's slotted in B. Next up in B, we've got the Gladiator, aka Audacious Fortuna Juvet. And main annoyance thing with Gladiator is his zone, because it's so safe, and that the fact that you can feint the second part of it, you know, that's pretty annoying. But that is, I think, probably going to get changed, because I know Glad's in the testing grounds as well. Also, when people attack and Glad's just, you know, dodge punch, pretty annoying. Toe stab ganks, I think we can all agree, also pretty annoying. But other than that, when he's, just besides, like, a toe stab and whatnot, I mean, I don't think his skewer is that annoying. Yeah, it can be pretty good. A good Glad can definitely mix you up, but again, he does have reflex guard, and his deflect is, again, not the most reliable thing, I would say. But yeah, Glad, I don't know, it's just hard for me to put a lot of characters high who have reflex guard. I just it's just such a detriment to being in there. And yeah, so that's the main thing, but he definitely does have some annoying things to him. Well, next up in the B tier, we have the Jormungandr. Honestly, there's a couple things with Jorm. A Jorm without feats is, I think, B, because still kind of annoying. A Jorm with feats is A, potentially towards S. I think I had Jormungandr as my Sultan of Smell last time, if I do recall correctly. It's because the feats are fucking annoying on the character, right? It's just healing, stackable shields, all that BS. You have, you know, Vengeful Barrier, and that stuff's really annoying. In, like, 1v1 situations, they're not nearly as bad without any of that stuff. You know, you do get the pressure from this, and having the actual Nutbuster 3000 is pretty damn good damage still. I think it's... Is it 50 still? It's not 50, it's 38. Why would it be 50? It's 38, but that's still one of the highest attacks in the game. They do this thing, the fucking electric slide right here. That thing tracks a long, long ways away. So, yeah, you gotta watch out for that too. But I think more so in 1v1s, Jorm isn't as bad. But definitely with feats and in gank situations, it is woohoo. That is, I'm getting a whiff of it already. All right, next up in B, we got Zerk. I know people don't like Zerk due to just all the hyper armor. Again, I think that's probably going to change once we get the testing grounds in here. But, you know, personally, I think it's just, to deal with the Zerk, you just got to not be going for parries as frequently. You just got to go just kind of on the blocking route. So I understand that. Berserker makes sense, though, why he would have hyper armor, just because of all that shit. But yeah, he's actually a pretty fun character to play, not even gonna lie. And his deflect is very satisfying to hit off as well. But I understand the hyper armor pretty much on everything being making him kind of smelly. I can get that. But again, reflex guard, kind of shit. So he's got some ups and downs to him, but I think that hyper armor will probably get changed when we get into the testing ground. So Zerk in B. All right, next up in B, we have Shaman. Honestly, Shaman, I was on the cusp of putting in A, but again, I just can't really justify myself putting in reflex guard characters into anything higher than B in terms of the smell personally. But she does have probably the most out of the assassins, right? She can do her jumps, she can do bashes, she can, you know, go for heavies off of it, she can do her bite, obviously, once someone's bleeding, which still does a fuck ton of damage. Even if she misses the bite, she can go ahead and do that. She has soft feints from the heavies. You can also soft feint GB. And then on finishers, she has She has unblockables, which again can be soft fainted, making it pretty easy. Plus, her dodge attack has really, really good frames. So, pretty fucking annoying to deal with, don't get me wrong. But again, she's kind of got low health. You can kind of catch her out on some certain things. And, you know, if she's not able to really apply her bleed too much, you should be kind of okay. So, I can't really justify putting her in A, but I think B's fine. Next up in B, surprisingly, right, we got Kensei. People are probably thinking, but Tony, you are Kensei main. Why do you not put in D? You think balanced character. You put him in B, you are big loose noob. Mainly, I don't think I play potentially like a smell when I play Kensei, but I can understand people who get annoyed at people who just, you know, light spam because it has really good range on Kensei, not necessarily due to the speed. Also, only Swift Strike gamers, but again, if you're getting beat by a Swift Strike gamer, that's kind of on you. But it is a very, very good dodge attack, don't get me wrong. Or you're just people who are zoning essentially everything. I mean, his zone is very, very good and hits essentially all the way around him with like the second hit. So I can understand if you go up against people like that, that it's pretty annoying. But in general, I think that Kensei has way more to offer than that. It's like Nature's Wrath. Once you're using Nature's Wrath, you've unlocked his full potential. But yeah, in general, I can understand why people could get annoyed with some Kenseis. So yeah, that's the main thing. But I don't think he should be higher into like A or anything like that matter. So just B. All right, next into B is Hidokiri. Now, admittedly, in like fours and ganks, Hidokiri is kind of garbage. I'm not even going to lie right there. But maybe this is a personal attack on them. I hate fighting them still because I find that their heavy animations and stuff are extremely weird. And also, when you're in 1v1s, it's just essentially, are they going to kick or are they going to not kick? And then even if they don't kick or not kick, they can always just hold it down for a sweep. It's just kind of 50-50 gaming right there for the Hidokiri. But like in gank situations, they are kind of garbage, so I do understand that. But I think it's just a personal attack on me. I've always thought this character is smelly, so that's why they're in B. And finally, in the B, we have Jang Jun. Most annoying part about him is probably, you know, his dodge attack is pretty good. You can GB out of it, and it's not as good as someone like Tiandi's or whatever, but it is a pretty solid thing to do. He can regenerate with Sifus, which isn't that super annoying. Also, his choke buys a ton of time and can essentially, like, eat through some people's, like, entire revenge meter if he gets a parry on that, so I understand how that's pretty annoying. Also, I guess his parry riposte can be slightly annoyance as well when you get a parry and then like the full 360 unblockable. I get that. Don't worry. I get that indeed. He's got a lot of stuff to him, but I don't think he's like incredibly annoying. It's just like, yeah, when people are just doing the dodge attack mix-ups over and over and over again on all your attacks and you might not be able to get in range or whatever because they have decent iframes, then yeah, I can understand that. But Mr. Jang Jun, it's a solid B. He's got a little bit of a smell. It's like, hey, just apply some deodorant, please. And yeah, so that's it. That's it for him. Now we are in the A tier. The A tier are essentially the characters that, well, they just are very smelly and I don't like them at all. Then you shouldn't like them at all either. But if you do, then that's completely fine because that's your opinion. But in the first one we have is Warden, especially new Warden, very strong. It's got unblockables to all sides. Any attack can chain into shoulder bash. That is very good. Even the third tier shoulder bash into a heavy can chain into a shoulder bash. That is, they basically made the character, they removed the back dodge shoulder bash, but they gave him shoulder bash on everything and also made his other attacks better. And he can also now hit more externally on his side heavies. So, yeah, it's pretty oppressive to deal with indeed, which is why Warden gets the A tier. Next in A is Black Prior. I don't think that's really a surprise. You guys have probably seen that I don't like this character. Essentially has everything, has crushing counter lights, has a bash that's pretty much not punishable. He also has a flip that he can cancel recoveries with. So again, can't really punish him. He also has undodgeable heavies right there. He has a unblockable essentially from neutral. He is just fucking stupid and annoying to deal with, and he can also debate with his dash forward into GB's Black Prior. You know, it's the edgelord's favorite character, but holy crap, dude, this man needs a shower or 30. But yeah, just can't deal with him. All right, next we got Conqueror. Conqueror is honestly my contender for the Sultan of Smell, because there's literally nothing positive about this character in my opinion. He's boring to play against. Has so many different tools. He's got his all guard, obviously, which people cancel into a lot. He's got his delayed shield bash. He can do his guard break too. You can spam that quite a bit. He's got, you know, shield basher even as a feat. Obviously, he's got the zones. It's just so long to even fight a Conqueror. Plus, with his feats, can help him stay alive for a very, very long time. there's just really not too much fun in general going up against this character in any stretch of the imagination. Even if you like they do bad, they'll probably stay alive like 90% longer than the rest of the people on the map. So it's it's just no fun for really anyone. Just kind of a stinky character in general, and I kind of wish they would just make their way out of the 4-honor game. Next up, we have the Poopmonger, aka the Poopmonger. So essentially, Warmonger. Main issues, frame advantage obviously is pretty annoying. She has the bash too, where she can essentially looks like she's about to full on bash you, but she can pause it kind of like to how Warden was able to, and it's pretty hard to deal with. She has like good catch material with the stay here, which she can feint as well. Her feats are also pretty annoying, not quite as annoying as they were before. She was definitely the Sultan of Smell when she first came out. But yeah, definitely just a strong character in general, and I think that a lot of people play her even in competitive because she just has a lot of tools and utility. Very good. The zone hits things that it probably shouldn't even hit. It'll hit like someone who's to my back right. This zone will hit them. Makes no sense. The character just got a lot of good stuff, to be honest. Not really too many downsides to the Warmonger. All right, next up we have the Warlord main issue, probably Crashing Charge, right? Crashing Charge is so good, you can also fucking chain it. Over and over again if you hit them like correctly off of walls, which is not fun. He also has he's got his headbutt, he's got an undodgeable zone, he also has superior lights on whatever, so that's you know, you don't have to go for parries, especially in like ganks and whatnot. He's got hyper armor on his heavies, although it does come up a bit late. It is still pretty good. He has good damage on his heavies as well. He's got an all guard, which is pretty solid, not really utilized as much, but yeah, the crashing charge is probably the most just because of how much stamina damage it does to people, and it can, you know, obviously knock them on the ground and you get good punishes. But it's pretty damn insane. I think it has super armor on it as well, if I do recall. I could be wrong on that, but yeah, being able to chain it like over and over is super crazy to me, and I don't know why that has gotten changed, but yeah, Warlord is just very strong all the way around. All right, and now we actually have Shigoki, which again might be surprising, right? Reputation 70, putting him in the A tier. That's one below S in terms of smell. I personally, again, don't think I play too smelly in terms of Shigoki. I like to just do mostly like variable timed heavies and whatnot, but I get that the light with hyper armor on it is one of the smelliest things that you can just do in the game, and people will do it over and over and over again no matter what attack you're throwing to interrupt on, you know, like dodges and stuff, you know, they just do it over and over again. So I understand it can be kind of hard to deal with. If you can get parries on them, yeah, it's pretty good. Shigoki still does have issues, you know, obviously with his like, you know, Demon's Embrace being pretty punishing if you miss still, and he is getting changes as we know to help with like roll catch, and you know, removing of this hyper armor from the light will be a pretty good thing to lower him on the smell rater, but a lot of Shigokis do unfortunately play just, you know, with the light hyper armor, so it kind of sucks. You know, my man's getting stank from people that, you know, don't deserve to be giving my man the stank, right? My man deserves to be clean and crisp, but you know, sometimes out in these streets people be doing tactics that we don't like, so yeah, that's unfortunate for Shigoki. All right, and the final character in A is the Tiandi, and oh my god, I think they have shot up the leaderboards on the smell index. I don't know what they were rated before, but this character is just so fucking annoying with the zones and the lights, and especially the Hrongni Hwifi and Mie is just, it's impossible. You know, they do say they have guard break vulnerability, but I kind of find that impossible, to be completely honest, because they kind of like be moving backwards from you, so you end up whiffing your guard breaks more so than not. They've got a bash, even if they miss the bash, right, they can still go into a heavy instead. It's pretty crazy, plus the feats in Dominion, pretty much they're not gonna die if they have their third and fourth feat because they'll heal and they'll also get shields when low. Kind of freaking stupid, but essentially it's just this over and over again. You guys have seen the POV you main Tiandi video, and that one, you know, I don't like those videos, but that's probably the most accurate one that was made. Like, holy crap. It is... Just thinking about Tiandi makes me kind of want to vomit. And now we are going into S, the Sultan of Smell, the smelliest character in For Honor. And I know you guys are probably going to be very surprised with the pick, but it is going to be Griffin. Wow, who would have thought? I probably, under normal circumstances, would have put... Conqueror in it, but I just find that you see more Griffins in the game than you do Conqueror, so that's kind of one of the main reasons. Let's talk about Griffin, all right? Nissa Dingle, fucking annoying. Neutral Bash that can also, even if you miss, throw a light or heavy after. That's kind of stupid, right? Kick, although you can dodge it, does a fuck ton of damage, and especially if you're not locked onto them in like a gank, it pretty much guarantees hits. It's pretty stupid. They can also, just by doing their bashes over and over again, if they do their kicks and whatnot after, like they just bash, light, kick, they can just bait it out by doing, you know, bash, light, GB to catch the dodge, all that good stuff. Classic indeed. It's just an amalgamation of all the things from every faction that you probably hate, it all wrapped up into one. So Griffin, it's just so much Nissa Dingle. Like, if you can bait it out, right, it's easy, it's an easy parry because they can't feint it, but they just have so much. I mean, like, with the neutral bash and everything, and it's just so much. It's so oppressive. It's so stinky. This character hasn't even gotten changes, hasn't even said that they were going to get changes. You know, you can still deal with them. It's just the fact that you probably see, like, 2 to 3 of them per match, whether they're on, like, one team or on the other. I've had plenty of matches where the entire enemy team's all Griffin, so those are never any fun. So I don't think anyone really enjoys that, unless you're probably playing him. If you're having a bad time, you probably just go ahead and play Griffin because he's pretty easy. There's not too much that you really need to know or do with him to actually do decent. So the character is smell, just absolute smell. I think the smelliest that I've ever thought a character had been, just due to the sheer amount of him. And I just got to put him in here at S. I think it's a clear-cut winner for this one. And that's going to do it for the video, guys. You guys can let me know what you think about my smell index updated. I think it's relatively accurate in terms of smell. It's not necessarily, you know, a true tier list of, like, strengths of characters, but just characters that I think are smelly, just don't like playing against. It's just you don't have fun, really. So I'll put the list up again here for the people who want to see the entire thing, just in case you forgot who was where. So the Sultan of Smell, obviously Griffin. I think it might stay that way for a bit if he doesn't get any changes. But it's just one of those things, you know? I hope you guys did enjoy this video. I probably won't be doing more of these, like, tier list type stuff because kind of overdoing that. I did, like, 20 of them in 2019 or whatever it was. So I think I definitely did my fair share of them. So we'll not be doing that anymore. So, again, hope you guys did enjoy. I am back for my break, so you will be seeing me stream and everything. So I do appreciate that, and I will talk to you guys in the next one. Peace.